the Dennis Clark Art School, and today we're still busy with two-point perspective. And what I'm going to show you is how to, let's put it this way, we have a nice photograph of an icon, something that is very, very well known, and when you draw it, it needs to be reasonably accurate, because if you get out of proportion, people are going to notice it immediately. Landscapes and lots of others, and other normal buildings, it's not a problem. But when you've got something that everybody knows, that's where the problem begins. So I'm going to show you why we've got a photograph of a very well-known icon, and you need to, let's say for argument's sake, I'll show you how you can, from the photograph, you can make it bigger, or you can reduce it accurately. And I'll show you a nice simple way, and let's go and have a look first, see what icon I've got for you. Right, you most probably recognize this one. This is the Arc de Triomphe in Paris, and very, very well known. And we had a bit of a skew photo, and what I've done, I've straightened it out like I did in one of my previous videos. Check that one, show you how you straighten it out nicely so you have everything nice and perpendicular. So a lot of little tiny little details inside here as well too, and we're going to simplify the smaller details. That you can get away with quite easy. Obviously, the bigger the thing is, the more detail you're going to start showing it. The smaller it is, the less detail. So let's go and show you the board. Here, what I've done is to be able to do it nice and accurately, to get all the angles correct. What we do is you need to find out where the vanishing points are, so to get these angles correct. So what I've done is I've got a bigger sheet of paper, and for the size that I'm going to do it, all right, let's have a look at this one first. We've got a vanishing point one here, a vanishing point across here, and here I've put the actual photograph. I've cut, made a print, stuck it out on the bigger piece of paper, and we're looking at it from the corner. It goes away this side, it goes away that side. So what I've done, I've measured here from the eye level, which is the horizon. You can see that from the little people that are standing down the bottom here. You can judge the actual size of this thing. It's very, very tall. And I've measured it from the top to there, is 127 millimeters, and I've marked out, in other words, what I've done is I've taken a ruler, drawn the eye level nice and horizontal, and then I started to take these lines on there and then draw them where they meet. That's the vanishing point too. Similarly, I've done it on the other side. And then what I've done is I've measured from that corner to the vanishing point. On this size of print, it's 186 millimeters, and this side is 204 millimeters. So the person is not standing 100% square on this one to give it that absolutely even size, but that doesn't matter. Very seldom you're going to look at exactly, it's 45 degrees this way and 45 degrees that side. You need to do what it looks the best for you. So we've got that one, we've done that. Right, now we need to come along and start making this one. We're going to make this one a little bit bigger. I've got 127 millimeters, and we're going to make it 135, only a little bit bigger. Any bigger than that, we need a much bigger paper, and etc., etc. But I'm showing you the principle of how you're going to do this. So let's just put this one to the side a bit. And all right, let's put this one on the top. What I've done is, let's do this one here first. Right, let's zoom into this. Right. Here is the size of the one that I've got here. What I've done is I've measured that 127, then I've measured from that corner to this edge, that corner to that edge. That we need to get it into the right proportions. What I've done from here to there is 67 millimeters, and from there to there is 42 millimeters, and you can see I've got it here. There is the basic outline, and the 127, 67 and 42, and that's across there, and that's the 186 and the 204 that I showed you earlier on. Okay, now we need to get a proportion, because we're going to make that one, which is here, we're going to make it a bit bigger, and that length is going to be, as I mentioned, 135 millimeters. Now we need to work out the ratio of how much bigger that one is to this one. So what you do is you take the biggest number, which is 135, divide that one into it, which we've done here, 135 divided by 127, and that gives you 1.063, and that tells you that the big one here is 1.063 times bigger than this one. And then you can take any measurement that you want off the thing and multiply it by that, and you'll get the correct measurement to put on. Now, if we want to make it smaller, what you need to do is you divide, take those two, swap them around, you take the smaller one and divide the bigger one into it. Then you multiply, and that gives us 127 divided by 135, gives you 0.94 times. In other words, any measurement that you take off your thing, you multiply it by 0.94, it will reduce the size, and then you can get that one measure from there, and then you can work out with any type of thing. You can use, not necessarily for this, but any other thing that you do. You need to get the proportion of the one size to the other. And the nice way to remember it is, which way around you put these, is if you want to enlarge, take the biggest number divided by the small number. If you want to reduce it, take the smallest number divided by the biggest number. In other words, the big number for enlarging, the smaller number for reducing. Very easy way to remember that. Now, we've got that, we've got the 1.06. So now we take the 67, multiplied by 1.06, so we get 71.2 millimeters. In other words, it's increased from 67 to 71. We take the 42, multiplied by 1.063, and you get 44.6. So for all practical purposes, that's going to be 71 millimeters. And this one here is going to be 45 millimeters. And then I've got it here. There's the new basic dimensions. It's 135. Now let me just take that up to there. So there's your basic shape. And we have 71 from the corner, 45 to the corner. So this, you can see, is a nice reminder for whenever you want to do anything. I've got everything nicely here for you to do it. All you have to do is just change the numbers. In other words, that's the number that you're going to change, and that's the number here, etc. In other words, you do that. Right, let's put this to the side, and then we now need to start plotting out. I've got a sheet down the bottom here. We need to start plotting out where these lines are going to be. So we need a piece of paper. So I've got a scrap piece of paper here. And let's set out now the top one. Now I'm going to put this. Here's the eye level. That line is there. There is a horizon. So now we're going to make a little ruler. So each of where that line comes, you're going to make a little mark here. A mark here, there, there. Get the basic one. There's a basic one up top here. That little corner, that little corner, that little corner, and the one right at the top. I'm not worrying about the scallops, is that? Just the basic lines that go through. When you got that one, you can always interpolate extrapolate these little ones in between. So, alright, let's put these little ones here. That. You got that, that, that. Now, what I've done is, this is a piece of paper. Take a line, any line, before, in other words, this is, assume this is completely clean. Take that line, we come along, and we're going to put that new height in, you see? So, there, those lines. This line here is actually, the bottom of this paper is the eye level. So you got that one, you can see what I've done here. I've marked that one, that one is across there, those two are there, that is there, and then there's another one up the top here. Okay. Now, we've got that, which is this line there. Now we have the vanishing point, which we measured out. It was 197. And we got that one, and we brought it out to the side. Let me get this other one here. It must be easier to look at this stage. Yeah, I've made it actually a bit too 200 there, but it's close enough. So you got that point, and what you do then is you take that point, and let's add this other little one in, which we didn't put in. We run that right up past this point here. Each line through there into these ones. What happens is now you're getting the right angles for all these. Now you can, if you want to reduce a smaller one, you take a vertical line of the piece of paper. If you want it that height, you just mark those ones, and you have the exact points that you need for the bringing them down. Here, our one is, we've taken that one, and I've taken that, and then what you do, you just shift that along, let's get the height that we need. The height is 135, so we get a line, and you move, there's the 135, Let me just mark this line across here. You can see it. Here's the bottom edge of this paper. Take that and you move the ruler perpendicular to this one here until you have the 135. In other words, here is 135. You see it's too short. You want to bring it across here at 135. That's a little bit too high. So you need to bring that one through to there where it's 135. Draw a line. Then you can take that. Let's make a new little ruler. We take that one. And there's the bottom end. And now we're going to do that. You can see that's a top here, so we have it that much bigger. Then take this one, let's go to our drawing where we're going to be enlarging this one. And what I have done is I've drawn a pencil line. Let's go along and mark it up for you. Now this is the eye level. Let's start it out. Obviously when you're going to do a finished painting, this line is going to be, you can leave it in pencil because it's not part of the drawing itself. But just for purpose of us showing the, how to draw this, I'm going to make this a solid line going straight through. And what happens is this paper that I've got is a bit too short to get my vanishing point on this side. So what I've done is I've stuck a little piece of paper on the side. So let's see. We need now to zoom out back to where we were. There we go. There you can see the little paper and our little dimensions that we've got. I've drawn a vertical line up top here. And let's mark that 135 up top. And that's the corner which you're going to have that line showing down anyway. It's all the way down. So let's draw that line down to there. So there's the corner, and that's the 135 up top there. Now we have, we worked that one out, 186 and 204. So let's put here 186. Sorry. It's 197. The original one's 186, it's now going to be 197.7 and 198. So we bring that out here, so there's 200 millimeters, 198, comes to this point here which I marked. There's the one vanishing point. Let's mark it vanishing point number one. Then the other one was, it was 204, become now 217, which I've marked down here. So there we bring that to 217, 210, 15, 217. So there's the other one here, and that one is vanishing point number two. So there are the 2-point perspective. Now we take our little ruler that we had and set it up there. Let me just take, yeah, I need to, where's my pencil? Take my pencil. little pencil marks opposite those. And let's take this ruler so it's easier to see. And I'm going to take my pencil and bring those lines across. Right, before we do that, let's come along and we need to measure the width. No use drawing all these lines right across there. So there's 71 and 45. So we got there. 71 and 45. 40, 45 is at that point. So what we need to do now is to draw those lines parallel up there. Now you've got that. Easy way to get that there is this is 71, so let's mark 71 up the top here and 45 across here. And then we draw a pencil line across and that will give you this nice and vertical. Where's the other one? Yeah, there we go. Now this is the very top one that we've done. So let's do the very top one from that point down to here. That will go through to there. So we need that one a little bit higher up. All right. Let's, I don't do ink right yet because we need something to go past. So let's just get that pencil mark.
Now we have the basic lines through here, and then we know this is going to be, those lines are going to be exactly in proportion, etc. Now we're going to be going lines across here. So we're going to do the same thing. Yeah, so just here, which we haven't seen before. So let's get back to our original one. Here we come. Yep. We're going across. And yes, there's longer lines, that's the corner. We've got that one. There, there, there. You've got this one, a little bit of button that comes out, so you've got that, that across here. And what's there? There's a button, so you've got that one, there's one corner, and there's the other one. Okay, this is pretty much on the right side, and that's on the left side. So you don't get mixed up. Now let's get back to our other sheet. And that's the one, which is the line, through to the original, there's the right side. Here's the right corner, there's the right one. Then, there we go. Here's the bottom of the line here. Got that, across here. Now, yeah, you can take any point that you want to, it doesn't matter. The difference between here is the closer you make it, the wider it is, and the taller it becomes. Otherwise, you're a long way. If you put it up here, and now you're a long piece, you make a taller one, bring it closer. So, smaller one, you can bring it out. As long as you just bring, from where you made that one, bring all those lines so that you can come. And, let's get it, these lines here. And we need that length, which is, on the right side. You've got it here, it's 45 millimeters. So we need that height to be, in here, 45. So take that one. Let's cross there, move it down up there until we've got 45. So I've done that already. There's the green line from there to there is 45. And that's what you do. So now we take this one, and we take the right hand side. Here is a corner. And we go up to that, onto that green line, and we mark these lines here. Bring it to that one, you can see that's taller than there. So we take that one, turn it around, that is on the right side. Now, another one here, from the left side. Just any place here, from those through, those, there's a taller. And that one there is going to be your, back here again, it's going to be 71 millimeters, which is on the left side, it's the other left. And there's this one here, so bring that one up there to 71, and this is from there to there 71. And we're going to take that other corner again. And the right side is at the main corner, so we're going to do that. That one here. There's a line, then we're going to move these. Then we've got the left side, and the right side is the corner. Now we've done this one. Then we're going to do ours. And here. Now you can see the line here, for that one, that line is here, there's a center line. Now we're going to make a little marks here. Now you have the field, and you just...
The original one. And we're going to come here. Put that across, and there's a bit of longer line, so that's the corner. You got that one, there, there, there. You got this one, there's a little abutment that comes out, so you got that, that, across here. There's the width of the little abutment. So we've got that one, there's the one corner, and there's the other one. Okay, this put here, this is on the right side, and that is on the left side. So you don't get mixed up. What I've done is we go back to our other sheet. And that's the one we put a line through to the original. Oops, wait a minute, that's the right side. Let me just get myself organized here. Here's the right corner, that's the right one, and there we go. Here's the bottom of the line here. You got that across there. Now here you can take any point that you want to. It doesn't matter. The distance between here doesn't matter. The closer you make it, the wider it is, and the taller it becomes. Otherwise, you've got a long way. If you put it out here, it narrows. You've got a long piece. You can make a taller one, bring it closer. If you've got a smaller one, you can bring it out. As long as you just bring from where you've made that one, bring all those lines so that you can then come and let's get it inside here. And we need that length, which is on the right side. We got it here. It's 45 millimeters. So we need that height to be in here at 45. So we take that one. Take that across there, you're going to move it parallel up there until you've got 45. So I've done that already. There's on that green line, from there to there is 45. And that will give you that. So now we take this one and we take it on the right hand side. And here is the corner. And we go up to that, onto that green line, and then we mark these lines here. Bring it to that one, you can see that's taller than there. Then we take that one, turn it around, that is on the right side. Now, I've done another one here for the left side. Just any place here, draw those through those, it's a taller, and that one there is going to be your back here again, it's going to be 71 millimeters, which is on the left side. You see the L for the left, and there is this one here. So we bring that one up there to 71, and it is from there to there 71. And we're going to take that other corner again, and on the right side there's the main corner, so we're going to do that. Put that on here, there is the line, and we're going to mark these. Now we've got the left side and the right side, and there's the corner. Now we're done with this one. Now let's go to our one here. Now you can see that line here fits that one, that line fits here, there's the center line. So now we're going to make little marks here. Now if you're out in the field and you just want to do a normal little sketch like we've normally been doing, that's not a problem. You can come along and do it like I've been all my others, just guess the size, etc., bring it in and do all. But here I'm teaching you how to do a nice one, bigger, and you want to do it for a nice illustration, for argument's sake, and that's how you can do it. So now I forgot to bring my triangular set square, but anyway, we can do this by eye. These are the short little ones. Let's put this here. You can see we're going to put these short little ones here, and those the long ones, so these are short ones. I'm just going to put a few short ones in here. And yeah, I think this one goes much higher up. That one. I'm judging parallel this line, I can also judge this line across here. But reasonably parallel, so I can then bring that line up there. And this one is now the width of the width. It also goes pretty high up. And that one goes up there. Okay, so there we got those. Now we can see that this here is your internal, that's the thickness of the wall, and that one ends across here. So we have that line across there, which is this one across here. And from here, you, some of these shorter ones, you can actually just do, put it in by hand. You've got that little piece there. This one is very slightly actually moving down to that one, so we just put this a little bit here. Yeah, gotcha.
here. something there.